This video is brought to you by the 3-Minute Board Game patrons. Keep us independent by supporting us on Patreon. Kia ora koutou and welcome to Cellulose in about 3 minutes. Review copy used. It has a solo mode. It's a game for 1 to 5 players. Playing time is medium and it's a moderately complex game. You are a plant. No, seriously, you are. And it's your job to grow big branches and strong roots. Can you manage your water and nutrients to be the best plant you can be? As the game progresses, carbohydrate tokens will be added to the cell wall. When the cell wall is complete, the game will be over at the end of that turn. The winner is the player with the most growth points, which you get from many sources. Just look for the gold star leaf thing. Worker placement. You'll place your workers on the board to gain benefits. Card management. There are four types of cards you can use to your advantage. Player turn. Each player has a marker on the branches and root paths. You will start the round by collecting the income shown there. As the game progresses, you will move along these tracks. Each player will be on the track and you can't coexist in a spot. After collecting income, you will place one of your three workers on the board. Here you gain that amount of water shown on the left track. You may also place up to three of that water here in your colored section, but more on that later. Large spaces like this can hold one of each player's worker, but smaller spots can only hold one worker. Each time you use a water or CO2 spot, the water marker drops the space until none is available. At this space, you can spend 6 water and CO2 to create a single carbohydrate. And if you have the resources, you can do it twice by placing here. This location lets you add a carb to the cell wall, gaining the points shown. Carbs can also be traded in for ATP tokens here. These spots will give you the red protein markers and orange hormone tokens, while the top space gives you the subtle first player marker and lets you draw a card. These spaces let you grow your branches and root system. The cost to advance to a new space is shown underneath, and it grants you the points in the yellow star once and changes your income to the new amount on the right. You can also obtain cards here, paying the cost shown above them. Cards are not immediately replaced. If you have cards, you may take a card action as well as placing a worker. Starch cards cost you carbohydrates and generate lots of points and let you draw more cards. PSV cards have a one-off cost and let you reclaim one of your worker flasks from the board. Specializations reward points at the end of the game, this one for each PSV card you played. And enzymes have an effect when first played, then once you play any other enzyme, you may spend a protein to trigger the ability at the bottom of the card here. At the end of the round, the player with the most water in their area here advances their marker and scores points. This also grants them a bonus flask. Anyone not winning leaves their water for the next turn. Gray flasks may be placed in an area where you already have a flask. Reset the card display, then place one carb on the cell wall. Reset the water marker based on the symbol on the cell wall. Why would you like this game? Cellulose is a sequel to Cytosis, the worker placement game inside an animal cell. This time it's a plant cell, but the games share a whole pile of DNA. Cellulose is a silky smooth game that moves at a great pace. I was really impressed with how quickly it moved along. There's such very little downtime between turns, and I dig how the cell wall builds out both naturally and by player action, driving the game ever forwards. There's also just enough in the card play to be quite engaging, and building chaining enzymes can be really fun if you can get the engine going. Overall, a slick, well-designed game that leans into its theme really well and could be a staple for just about any group of gamers. The best thing about this game is the mini-game of placing water in the middle to get the extra worker. It's actually really engaging. However, almost all the game is very safe and sensible design work. Aside from the novel theme and the water game, it's all very normal resource conversion and worker placement. Nothing in the rules should shock or surprise experienced gamers, which makes it great for some audience, but those seeking novelty might be disappointed. Genius Games have built a great niche with their science games. Check out Genotype. And also, the original game in this series, Cytosis. Cellulose, it's growing on me. And if you enjoy this video, hit the notification button, like, share, and subscribe to the channel.